In this video, we are going to look to an old radio magazine in the Netherlands, and it is of 1966, February 1966. On the front page, we see this beautiful image of a factory where tape recorders were made. And it looks quite modern, even now in 2021. We are going to move to the next page. It is, you can see, February 1966. I was 11 years old, and I surely can remember this beautiful magazine that I really had in my bookshelf in those days. Later, of course. Beautiful advertisement of a disc player. I have to say, skip this because there are many other things I want to tell. The KEF loudspeaker box. Car electronics. Here the first page with the content. A lot of advertisement, of course. Power supply transformers, transistor amplifier, Robijn. So Rubin, as far as I know. And this was my first radio. When I was approximately 12 years old, the Pioneer radio. It was a kind of crystal receiver with a 0A79 as detection diode. And this was the, say, the next step. There were three versions, and this was the first one, and this is the final that you could make as a radio hobbyist. Valkenberg in the Netherlands, in the Kinkerstraat in Amsterdam. RC generator. Advertisement, a lot of advertisement. And I have to skip here again an advertisement for that Robijn transistor amplifier, 10 watt. I'm sure they made it with germanium transistors. Absolutely sure. You could make yourself an oscilloscope. It was a kit. Of course, the bandwidth of that scope was not very big, in my opinion, but anyway. Again, tape recorders. Of Aristona. Aristona was the kind of B brand of Philips, but they made very, very good electronic devices. I had a few of them, a few of Aristona amplifier, one amplifier as far as I can remember, and an Aristona CD player in the 1990s or 1980s, not very sure. Here, the practice of a bad dream, and the author of this article is very, very critical about, working conditions in those days, where they worked to make television sets, tape recorders, etc., etc. He tells, or she tells, I don't know who have written this, but I think it's a man, tells that this is very boring, completely boring, that work. And, well, I cannot agree with that. Of course, I'm interested in electronics, and, well, why is it boring? And now, at the moment, exactly the same things happen in China. In 2021 and the earlier years, people in China are making our, say, smartphones, our television sets, etc., etc. And in fact, exactly the same happens there. So, it's a quite negative article about industrial production of electronic devices anyway. Here, again, a picture where a woman is busy to make, I think, a television set. I'm not sure about it. Anyway, it was all handwork and many things were made mechanical. Not like it's nowadays, everything is related to computer technology. So no moving parts, etc., etc. But in those days, 1966, every electronic device consisted of many moving parts. Tuning capacitors, channel switches, all kinds of other switches for frequencies, high frequencies, low frequencies, etc. A circuit about a converter, a VHF converter. Interesting is this. The use of a so-called Legger line, two wires spread out with a certain distance in between, and here a cable. And as far as I could see, that Legger line is used here. Don't know that exactly, but anyway, the principle is quite simple. The length of the two wires tell us something about the wavelengths. So there's a direct relation between the wavelengths that has to be tested in this way. And when you lay a copper bar on the top of these two wires, the wavelength is shortened. That means that it goes, in fact it's a coil, it goes to another frequency. Shorter wires, higher frequency, longer wires, lower frequency. Anyway, and here they tell about the whole test procedure. Again, the tuner. And here in real, this of course will be a tuned circuit, kind of coax cable that's used in this case as a tuned coil to a very high frequency, VHF or UHF. Here an interesting article about the fatal low frequency transformer. It's all about a power transformer, and the whole article is of 1926, at least the experience are of 1926 approximately. And the problem was that a power transformer, mains transformer, after say a few months didn't work any longer, and when they opened it they found a kind of green slurry inside on the primary coil, and it had everything to do with the paper that they used. That paper was immersed in petroleum jelly, and petroleum jelly when it acts with electricity generates acids, and that acids dissolved the primary of the transformer. And here a test setup, and after say 5 months or so, I think the whole article relies to the tropics, Netherlands, Dutch, India or so. Anyway, a big green slurry was the result when the primary of the transformer got moist, and more important, there was there was a leak current flowing. So a DC current flowing in the primary, and that DC current caused electrolysis of the copper. That's important. And when they used other isolation materials in their transformer, the problem was solved. I'm gonna skip some things. Mini amplifier for everything to everyone interested in making a germanium transistor amplifier. Always the problem of this negative temperature resistor that's necessary to keep the circuit stable. Article about a KEF loudspeaker unit, very interesting. Small unit with good results, good frequency range, going from 50 Hz to 18 kHz or so. And this is very interesting. This was the so-called music machine of Schaub Lorenz, a European factory. And interesting is that it was a radio, but there was also a kind of big drum here that was a magnetic tape, and it was very broad, and there was a head that could be set to different positions, and there were approximately, as far as I remember and can see, 20 tracks. So you could directly make a radio recordings, and that big broad tape, magnetic tape, could record all these radio stations and music from the radio. Very interesting, I think. And here is another picture. Here you can see the drum. Very good. This is the drum with approximately, say, 20 tracks or so. Music tracks. So, kind of way to make endless recordings on a magnetic tape of music and radio programs. Very good idea. Here's some electronic circuits, automatic volume control of the preamplifier, how the motor has driven the drum. Here the pilot tone amplifier, here the underside of that beautiful tape recorder with unique properties for those days, 1966. I skip this. Of course, pickups and vinyl records were, say, in those days, one of the most important ways to play music. So a lot of tests in these 1960s magazines, audio, electronics, etc. You see the frequency characteristic of that pickup element. You can see it amplifies somewhat. There's a better, it's a good high response here, and here the frequency falls off. And there's also in the low frequencies a kind of more response. That's interesting. I think this element had a good properties. Wobulator. My camera runs almost out, so I have only 1 minute approximately. So it will stop. Schematic of that wobulator. Tape deck with a tube amplifier. Interesting to study that. Here the record heads and the erase heads and the end amplifier. It was quite simple, I think. They used this is a double triode pentode tube. The the Pento tube was used as end amplifier, and this is used as preamplifier. Frequency characteristics. And a measuring device with a high sensitivity, also interesting. Frequency divider here. You can use this principle, of course, up until now. This series of resistors, with this series of resistors, you can send in different voltages and say on the lower side of that frequency divider, it's a voltage divider. Sorry, it's a voltage divider. Go back for a moment here. Voltage divider. That's the most important thing. Anyway, that was a small mistake. We go further, further and further. This is interesting. The article is about errors in biasing a transistor. That's a very interesting subject and a very interesting article. This man has written many books. Dirksen, electronic books, and they are still on the World Wide Web. And this was someone who knew a lot, well educated about transistor technology. This is also the reason why you find on my YouTube channel always a potentiometer here in the baseline, a voltage divider. That prevents all these, say, problems with biasing one transistor. And by changing that voltage divider, often a 22K potentiometer, when you watch my videos, you can always set a transistor to a correct bias. And not so much calculations are necessary. That's very, very important for... especially when you are a beginner, when you copy circuits directly off the World Wide Web, it could be that the voltage divider on the base of a transistor worked in a specific case, but in another case could be that it doesn't work. Sherry balanced amplifier with transistors. They often had to use a transformer here. In those days, 1960s, in the 70s and the late 1960s, you don't see this transformer any longer. So all is made with, say, a handful of transistors, five or six or so. Transformers are always a problem.